Hola! Welcome to beautiful Benidorm. It's time for your favourite show with all the B words.
Buenos dias.
That's wicked.
There's bags full of bargains.
Everything's cheap and cheerful.
Cheap as chips.
There's bucket loads of beaches.
Beach is gorgeous. View is gorgeous. Just worried about getting a bit of a sunburn on our heads, aren't we?
And there's busloads of Brits, some here for a whole new life and the odd one who wants to be here forever.
I love Benidorm. I even want my ashes scattered here. I love it. Really, really love it.
But don't take us Brits' word for it. This girl's from Oklahoma.
I think there's something for everyone here. It's like Las Vegas mixed with, like, New Orleans, mixed with, like, Florida.
Everybody comes to Benidorm, so they don't like it. That's beautiful.
And we're not fools. That's why there'll always be bargain-loving Brits in the sun. Coming up, is it happy days for campsite king Happy Days Graham?
Not happy days at the moment.
The Essex bargain blingers are back.
Here's my lampshade that I made.
Yeah, she's proud of her there, chandelier lampshade.
And the heat on the street is getting to the pub crawl sales crew.
Every time I see a person, I think, €15, €15, €15.
It's a fact, Brits love Benidorm. Visitor numbers are on the up, and there's one main reason.
It's like the UK, but it's cheaper with a beach and the sun. Get tan.
Loving life.
Tan me beautiful.
And many of us wish we could stay even longer.
Quite possibly, yeah. I would like to move out here. Back home, you're freezing your backsides off.
The sun shines every day. That's why we chose to move here and live here, really.
Benidorm is home to an estimated 40,000 of us who feel the same and have left Blighty for a new life in the sun. And the newest arrivals are former bar manager Chris Green and hairdresser Gary Jones. They flew in today with nothing but a dream. Two suitcases, a hotel for three nights and $7,000.
And we've achieved that budget by selling things, by transferring money across. And
it wasn't a huge budget, you know. We didn't think, oh, we're going to come out here with, like, 20,000. And I think it can be done, definitely. You can make a life and a new start for yourselves anyway on a very low budget.
Oh, isn't that nice?
Oh, my God, it's... wow.
To add to the challenge, they've never been to Benidorm.
We wanted to have a new experience and a new challenge, and not knowing the place, even though we have done quite a lot of research here before we moved out here, is part, I think, part of the glamour of it.
And they've got similar reasons to leave the UK as most expats before them.
You don't really have a life back home, it's just work and... yeah, that's it, isn't it?
You know, walking around with an umbrella and Wellingtons all day.
It'd be just nice to have days off down the beach.
We've made it.
Well, we haven't yet.
But... no.
But there's no going back either way.
Failure's not an option.
Oh, no way, Jose. No. We can go home. Quite embarrassing, actually, wouldn't it? Going back home.
Yeah. Oh. After a leaving party, you can't go back home, can you?
No way, no. We'd have to move to another country, I think, wouldn't we?
Never face your family again.
The shame. So, first things first, the lads need an apartment.
We'd like a two-bedroom apartment. One bedroom is fine. Lovely balcony.
Ideally, we both said we want sea views or actually have nice views of somewhere beautiful.
That could be easier said than done. Their budget is so tight, they've only allowed themselves two nights in a hotel. And with high season approaching and demand through the roof, they need to stop frolicking in the sea and get to the estate agent. But if you're looking for a cheaper and easier place to lay your head in Benidorm, head for the campsites. Unlike most resorts, a massive chunk of the bargain-loving Brits abroad prefer a movable mansion on one of the 10 sites to an average apartment or a heaving hotel.
The community is absolutely fab. The people are fab. We've met, in fact, I would say I've got more friends here than we have back home.
From the moment we pulled on, people rallied around, said, do you want a hand doing this? Do you want a hand doing that? And
excellent,
you know.
You've got neighbours here. At home now, you don't feel like you've got neighbours.
Yeah.
And I can't think of anything bad about it at all, nothing. I love it.
And for a decade, the linchpin of the camping Villamar community was king of the clubhouse, entertainment manager Graham Happy Days Boland, who got that nickname because...
Happy Days, is it, sir?
All right, Happy Days.
At the end of the day, it's Happy Days, isn't it?
Happy Days.
Proper Happy Days.
But last summer season, after 10 years of long hours, bad health and increasing stress, he'd had enough.
This is definitely the toughest year I've had.
That tripod come right down, smacked me on the face.
Not happy days at the moment.
And he finally left his all-consuming job as entertainment manager.
When I left last year, my heart weren't in the job anymore. I just needed something fresh. Even though I live on here, I didn't go into the clubhouse much. I kept out of the way. So I needed to go recharge my batteries, go and visit the family, spend time with Jackie. That was absolutely fabulous. And of course, it was funny and strange because my phone wasn't going so much. I didn't really miss it.
With no definite plans, Graham got lucky when he was offered the weekday drive time slot at a local radio station. And today he's got a new studio to get used to.
Right, I've turned up at the new studios, but I haven't got a clue where it is. And I'm cut for time, which is happy day. So I'm going to take a wild guess and walk around this way. It should be somewhere around here. So I'm locked in a room all by myself. Nobody's knocking on the door. You know, like I say, I'm enjoying it. Right, then one of these keys should fit.
Hurry up, Graham, you're on air in 5 minutes.
That's no happy days. And this is a bit where I switch off now for the next 3 hours and become the radio presenter. And I haven't been here before, so it's a new studio. Nice views as well. So, yeah, proper happy days. Well chuffed. I can play some beautiful music and I can imagine people being in cars and in bars and things like that and listening and going, oh, I haven't heard that for a long time, so it's happy days. We're 20 seconds away now from going live. I've had a great day today. So, well happy today. Very happy.
I imagine 3 hours of work a day will do that to a person.
At the moment, I'm happy with them hours. And really, I wouldn't call the radio work anyway. You know, you're sitting there, you're enjoying it, you're playing the music, you're not rushing around. It's the happiest I've been for a long, long time. So it's proper happy days now. Here we go.
At last, happy days is truly happy.
Good afternoon. You listen to Fresh Radio 97 FM here with Happy Days Graham. We have gone live now. Good afternoon. I think the button was off. I've never made a mistake before, but you never guess what I've done. I've opened up the show this afternoon with making a mistake. So we'll start again. Good afternoon. You are here with Happy Days Graham until 8 o'clock this evening.
Oh, Graham, I'm sure no one will have noticed one little mistake.
If you have a request, 631 351 333. Right there, music coming up. Do you know what I think I've done? I think I'll give out the wrong phone number. Oh, dear me. Nothing else can go wrong today, surely.
It's not a massive problem, and on a stress scale of 1 to a 12-hour day at Villamar, I'd say it's about a 3. Coming up, selling a pub crawl in the sun isn't that much fun.
Got to be able to take rejection to get a lot of it.
And there's flat hunting fury.
We're here now and still nothing happening. I just think we need an answer like ASAP now.
There's one undeniable fact about Benidorm. People come here to party. The sun and sea are nice, but it's the bars, the cabaret, and being boozed up on a bucking bronco that many Brits love.
If you want a relaxing, quiet holiday, don't come to Benidorm.
This is the place to be for a weekend, for sure. It's got everything we want. It's funny. It's good.
You have naked people. You have people dressed up like chickens. And, like, no one really cares. No one's uptight here. Everyone's just, like, laid back and just wanting to have a good time.
And the fuel for this over-the-top behaviour?
It's cheap beer.
No, it's cheap drinks.
Just cheap beer. And
cheap booze. Fairly cheap for a beer.
Beer's quite cheap here.
Oh, yeah, all right, we get the picture. And one man who has just started an entire new business based on the Brits' love of a night out is Scotsman Graham O'Hagan.
The basic idea of our company is the pub crawl. So what we do is we take people every night of the week to five bars.
Graham's nights are based on the idea that Brits see Benidorm as a bonkers version of Britain by the Met.
I think it's familiarities of home. You know, you've got your sun, sea, sand. We've also got your cheap pints, your good nightclubs and nights out. It closes at 7 o'clock instead of 2 o'clock in the UK.
And it's that cheap, chilled and sunny life that convinced Graham to make a home and build a business here.
I find in the UK, you spend all day working to go home, to watch the TV, to pay the bills, to go back to work. I don't think in England you stop and smell the roses at all, you know? Whereas in Spain, I can go to the beach in my spare time and I can still afford to buy all the necessities of life.
To keep his dream life going, Graham has hired a hardy team to run the nights and sell tickets on the streets.
We have Damo, we have Sophie, and we have Cameron, who's the team leader. Them, I find them very enthusiastic on a daily basis, keeping in mind the working hours are quite long. But they come in with all the motivation and good fun.
I'm enjoying it, but it's a bit hot, and I love the sun. But walking around for 25 miles, 30 miles a day, it's pretty brutal. I think I've probably lost about a stone and a half, probably more.
Not everyone can do this job, it's really hard. You've got to be able to take rejection as well, so you get a lot of it.
I found this company, went on a pub crawl, embarrassed myself quite a lot, and then they gave me a job, so here I am.
The customers love them, absolutely love them. The reviews that come in, because fundamentally they're the product. People buy their tickets because they've met these guys.
The idea is to bring strangers together so they can feel part of the big fun group run by the reps. For Graham, the bigger the group, the more money he makes.
For the ticket, it's €15. You pay once. If you're here for a week, it lasts a week. If you're here for 2 weeks, it's going to last you 2 weeks. The money that's made through the company is obviously through the ticket sales. And for myself personally, it's through the commissions from the bars. We supply them with custom, and then in turn, they reward us for that.
But with the season only just starting, they need to keep pounding the pavements in searing heat to get the numbers up. Across town, Happy Days Graham's drive time show is almost over.
Right then, that brings it to the end of my show for today. Can I just say a massive thank you for everybody getting involved on the Mystery Voice today. Don't forget, it was, of course, Ian Botham. Yeah, I'll be back tomorrow at the same time.
But all is not as it was. His idyllic, relaxed new life as a radio presenter has just had a spanner thrown into it.
I was asked to come back to Villamar only last week. They needed somebody ASAP, somebody with the knowledge of how the clubhouse works. Will you come back?
But with his new chilled and happy life, he obviously said no.
So I said, yeah, I'll come back short term.
You what?
Till they find the replacement. Happy days, now back to Villamar.
Oh, Graham, why?
It's not as hard as what it was before, nowhere near it. It's not so many hours. Typical day in the life of Happy Days at the minute. Come up to the clubhouse around about 11 o'clock, sorting out the entertainment. Stay here till maybe 12:30. Do some research for the radio show. Go live on air at 5 o'clock. Stay on there till 8 o'clock. I'll come back here, get something to eat.
Bit of bread and butter, and I'll be happy days, eh?
Put the artist on.
We're now going to enter the world of cabaret.
That's it then. Finish at 12 o'clock. Go home, cup of tea, get into bed, start up the next day exactly the same.
Call me daft, but that sounds like a pretty full day to me. But secretly, I think he's missed the job.
I'm enjoying coming back. What they say is once it's in your blood, it's hard to get away from it, you know. But how long it'll take them to find a replacement, I don't know. But I haven't seen anybody come rushing through the door yet.
With an entertainment roster in disarray and long-term girlfriend Jackie over for the first time since the Villamar addiction kicked back in, the eternal struggle between his two loves has reignited. But it's different this time, as it's on Graham's terms, right?
I've got to get a cup of tea. If I don't get a cup of tea, I'll be... I know what I haven't done.
On this visit, it's been 6 days, and to be quite truthful with you, I haven't really had a lot of hours with him in the 6 days, but it's just good to be here and be together again.
For some unknown reason, it's a bit hectic.
Isn't it always?
Everybody just wants a bit of Graham, a bit of Happy Days. It's OK that he's back working. It's his choice. It's where he's happy, that's important.
Hiya, Robbie, it's only Graham. Hey, you know you're not on this week, don't you? It's 1 to 4 now.
Hopefully I'll get a bit of time with Graham today, but he is working, so we'll maybe catch a bit of lunch together, and that's probably about the height of it.
Don't know about lunch, but he's finally got his tea. Oh, dear.
Where are you? Right, give me 5 minutes. I'm going to get everything tied up by 1 o'clock, so I can spend a few hours with this afternoon. But today's been one of them days, but I think she understands, so see how it goes.
But 1 o'clock comes and goes. Hang on, aren't you off out for lunch?
I've got what? Half one, half two, half three, half four, half five. 4 hours.
For Jackie, these times are precious, so she's hoping it's just one last summer.
I don't know that Graham's going to be permanently here.
Yeah, right. So this week, miss this week, and then come back the week after, innit?
I hope not. Really, I hope not, because it frees him up to come to me in Belfast. It's easier to have time off when he's working just on the radio.
Do you want to do the Tuesday or the Wednesday?
So I hope he doesn't stay permanently, personally.
Right, that's it for me today. I'll spend some time now with Jackie.
Finally, he finishes, and it's 2 o'clock.
Are you ready, Jack?
Are you?
Yeah, come on.
Afternoon tea for one, Jackie?
Yeah.
Better than nothing. Well, one couple want away from the campsite. Retiree Susie from Essex and her Scouser husband, Waller, can't get enough of it.
Brilliant. Love the campsite, love the people.
Absolutely no regrets about coming this
year. Found one thing I don't like, not one thing. Which I say that every day. I can't find anything
that's,
I don't
that's
like.
True. You do say that every day, don't you? So she can't find anything here that we don't like, and I think I'm the same.
It's amazing.
It's worked out really well for us.
They were enticed by the weather and the lifestyle to spend 14 grand on this portable palace just over a year ago.
You've got a proper outdoor living, haven't you?
Yeah.
And I'm in the middle of making a chandelier, which I think would look lovely if I put a chandelier here. The more bling, the better.
But the inside wasn't exactly blinging, so they set about a full refurb, which wasn't always full of sun and fun.
Oh, God's sake, how much longer is this all going to take? It's getting on my nerves now.
No.
I have got it right. Now we've been in here for days on end. I'm really drained.
A very tiring and long year later, look at it now.
We have now finished putting this kitchen in. Husband made this table and that table for me. I've made the curtains, the pillars, so it all matches in.
We've had these wardrobes fitted. And then this is our bedroom.
And Susie has a name for her theme.
It's called Mid-Century Modern. Oh, hang on. Here's my lampshade that I made. I have had loads of people keep asking me for them as well.
Yeah, Susie's proud of her chandelier lampshades.
Very nice. How much did all this cost, if you don't mind me asking?
We've probably put about 32,000 into
this.
I've
put about 25.
No, not with the cost of the caravan included.
Yeah, caravan, then all the other bits. No, I don't think we spent 32.
I think we have.
I don't know then.
It's 30,000 sounds like a lot of money, but really, when you consider, it's virtually another home in the sun, and we're here really most of the time.
But even after all that dosh, it's still not completely finished.
The only thing we haven't done is the bathroom. And we've got all the stuff to make it, but we just haven't installed it all yet. And it looks a bit of a mess at the moment. Sue doesn't like anyone going in there.
No, I don't.
At the moment.
It's disgusting.
So it will be finished in 2 weeks.
Sounds great, but with their track record, I'm not filled with confidence.
She'll change direction.
Yeah,
at the
but
drop of
I
a hat.
Am bossy and I do want jobs done, but then I change my mind.
Yeah. She's very good at diversing.
Yeah. My daughter can't work with me because I diverse a lot, yeah.
And what is so diversing about campsite life?
The weather's great, food's cheap, drink's cheap, so we're always out and there's a big social scene.
You're looking very pretty, aren't it?
Here, you will absolutely meet and have a chat with a few people every single day. And there's always something going on. Hola.
I'm beginning to think that this 2 week deadline is a tad optimistic. In the old town, Benny new boys, Chris and Gary, have their own very real deadline. They've checked out of their hotel and have nowhere to stay unless they can find an apartment by the end of the day. Yeah, I know, but they do have a lead.
We're going to view an apartment today, a two-bedroom apartment, and it's got two bathrooms.
Yeah.
So I don't have to wait for you in the shower now.
And there's one added challenge. This is all new territory, as they've only been together 6 months.
I don't think you'll never know anybody until you live with them or been on holiday with them, and we've done neither, so, you know. So it's all a learning curve, really.
Quite a steep one. Today's first place is on for €600 a month, and they budgeted £3,000 for 4 months' rent and fees. All sounds great, except for the 30-minute suitcase drag to the other side of Levante Beach.
Oh, here we are. Wow. It looks quite posh, actually, from the outside, doesn't it? It's quite high up, isn't it? And
amazing views on the positive side.
We might get altitude sickness. Nice, like a palace, isn't it?
Helping the lads find a dream pad is Dutch estate agent Tiffany.
You're our Benidorm angel.
Let's cross our fingers. Come on, hopefully that we signed the contract today.
Yeah,
I hope so.
But before they even get inside, there's some bad news. Because Chris and Gary are jobless, the nervy landlord wants an extra £1,800 up front.
We can't, if that's the case, then I can't even be here next. We can't do it. No. Simple as.
Because we can pay, you know, like, 4 months thing, wouldn't we? Like we said we did originally.
We could pay 3,000, 2 months rent and a month's deposit and a finder's fee. Basically, she's asking now if we can have like 6 months rent up front, which we've kind of said 3,000 is going to be maximum to pay now.
Otherwise, you know, we're going to leave ourselves short, aren't we?
I don't want to pay out too much money.
Yeah.
Not at the minute. I'd rather leave it.
Definitely.
But it got there because we could have been told this before we actually traded here. Mm. Here. But I'm not backing down. 3,000 is the maximum I'm going to put down.
Exactly,
today.
And that's it.
No way.
No more.
Good lads, stick to your guns. £3,000 and no more. But might as well nip to the sixth floor for a sneak peek. I'm not good with heights, so I'll wait here for you.
Oh, wow. Oh, it's beautiful.
I'll get used to the height thing, just don't rush
it. Not that bad, what do you think?
Yeah, cool.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sounds like the £3,000 limit might be stretching. Now, like being homeless to motivate a deal. But there's another problem.
I'm not convinced that we're actually going to be able to move in today. So, again, it's more costing her tiles, isn't it? I just don't see it happening. Truthfully, I don't see it happening. I'd be very surprised. And why we can't just make a simple phone call here, now, while we've got everything, and move in. Spain, I suppose, isn't it?
I'm not sure that's how it works anywhere, Chris. Anyway, time to drag the bags back across town to the office. At least it's not uphill.
But it's just a hassle having to drag things about. Come on, let's go and see what they've got to say.
Is this actually?
Is it?
They have to call back. They are working on this moment, so they couldn't get any answer. We need an OK from the owners.
Yeah,
first. They
OK.
Can also not...
Well, we need an OK from the owners as well, you know?
Yeah.
Roughly how long is this going to take? See, it's a lot of messing about, isn't it? Just for...
I'm feeling sorry. I don't have the contact directly with the OMO. Unfortunately, it doesn't work like this in Spain.
We're here now and still nothing happening. I just think we need an answer like ASAP now, because I'm not waiting any more of my day now. Got the money, got the paperwork that we need, and we still don't have an answer. Do you know what I mean? And now we've got to hang about here waiting when we could be looking for an apartment to rent and moving in today.
Oops, someone's getting a little upset.
Let's can have a coffee, come on, you.
Let's have a drink of coffee.
Get off your high horse, let's mister. Phone.
I'm beginning to think this find a flat in 2 days in a foreign country without jobs plan might have some issues. Coming up, Susie's flushed with excitement.
This is the end of our work, so you can cut the ribbon.
And Chris and Gary have a decision dilemma.
God, I thought for the first time in my life I've made a decision.
Oh, my head's smashed. No.
What do we do?
Over at Camping Villamar, Happy Days Graham is hard at work looking for new acts.
Right, John, it's Graham.
And luckily for him, one bloke has done all the work and got in touch himself.
I've got a guy coming in to see me, Tim. He's new to Benidorm, so it's not somebody that I know. Apparently he's worked at one of the two big holiday camps back home, so we'll see.
54-year-old Tim Ames came to Benidorm 5 months ago to try and kick-start his cabaret career in the sun.
I did a gig here when I first got here, but since then, Graham's come back, so fingers crossed, we're going to have a little chat and see how we get on. Hello, Graham.
All right, Tim, how are you doing?
Not so bad, mate. Nice to see you, mate. You all right?
Lovely. How's it going?
It's going. Got some nice hotel gigs in, but could be a lot busier.
Yeah.
It's taken a while to crack the circuit. Longer than I thought it might.
That's Benidorm. It don't happen in 5 minutes. What kind of show is it you're doing?
I call it Tim Ames Swing Soul and Laughter, which is a sort of a broad band. It gives me a lot of flexibility to change the act depending on the evening. You know, standard Rat Pack type swing.
Yeah.
It's soul, stroke pop, sort of 70s, 80s. And then mucking about, lots of audience interaction.
A lot of the hotels and bars do like the tributes.
They do, because it's easy to sell to the punters, isn't it?
Straight away.
Absolutely. Whereas Tim Ames means nothing.
So, Graham, is he getting an audition?
I haven't got a problem. I'll give you a go. What about tonight? Just to give it a go, stick you on around about 9:15 if you want.
So just at a 40-minute spot, something like that?
Yeah.
As long as Tim isn't terrible, it's a win-win for both of them.
No, I thought that went all right. Little show tonight to see how it goes, and if that goes well, job's a good one, really, isn't it? No, I'm pleased with that. That's good. No, I like it.
Yeah, it went well. Bubbly character, nice lad. Bit of a comedian as well, which is good. Give him a go, give him a chance. I think it'll be all right, definitely, yeah. Happy days.
In the centre of Benidorm, it's team meeting time for the pub crawl company, and boss Graham is setting a target for the day.
OK, the target for today, guys, as always, is 30 tickets as a team. So, unfortunately, it's a small team pre-season, so it's going to be 10 tickets each. Be nice and easy.
With temperatures over 30 degrees, that could be easier said than done. But with £4 commission per ticket to bolster their basic wage of £160 for a seven-day week, there's a big incentive to sell.
Yeah, I see them as euros. Every time I see a person, I think, €15.
How sweet. And now it's time to find as many people to hit with the hard sell or the talk very fast without breathing sell.
Hi, all right, my name's Damo. Are you having a nice holiday?
Yes.
Oh, fantastic. Basically what it is, we're in a pub crawl on the British Square. It's the 5 main bars. It does cost €15 per person, but it isn't a lot of money because you will save money on your drinks.
Yeah, I get you.
But obviously with this, you can come every night as well. If you've been here for 2 weeks, you'll probably end up at the phone party 4 times in them 2 weeks.
Has the verbal barrage technique worked?
You'll definitely be there. That's fantastic.
2 down in 2 minutes. It's a good start. Wristbands on, money handed over.
Enjoy your day. We'll see you tonight. Bye.
It's time to move on.
That's why I enjoy going into the bars and stuff like that, because you can sit and give them a bit of your personality, and that's why they want to come with you. So they're buying you and they're buying that as a product sort of thing, if that makes sense.
Yeah, so basically people are just buying a night out with you and your mates.
Obviously, if you can't make a decision, obviously you need to speak to other 2 people. I'll write my phone number on here for you, and I hope to see you later on. Yeah, hopefully. They'll call us back and come tonight.
My number's all over Benidorm. It's ridiculous.
That's for different reasons. So.
Charming. As the day drags on, bit by bit, the team makes some sales.
You get the best drinks offers in the bars. You're here once, you may as well just do it.
I definitely. I'll get you game.
Well, like I say, even if you don't come tonight, you can come Thursday. So it doesn't matter.
It's going to be a little messy now, isn't it?
That's the best way, though. You're in Benidorm, it's meant to be messy.
Ticket sales are rising slowly, but the temperature's going through the roof. Are this lot bothered? No, it's conga time. Come on and do the conga. 5 miles away in Alfas del Pi, house hunters Chris and Gary aren't doing the conga. It's more of a silent, sulky suitcase shuffle to see another apartment. Having checked out of their hotel, time is running out, so let's hope estate agents Tiffany and Elena have something decent.
At the minute, we're still waiting for the landlord to get in touch about the previous apartment that we've just been to view. This does sound like a better deal, but it just depends on what the apartment looks like, really.
Oh, don't get all negative yet again, don't we?
No, it'll be fine, I'm sure.
But before Chris is even inside, he doesn't like it.
I don't like it. Number three.
Nice colour, mind.
I hate it. Horrible. There's no point wasting any more time. I'm not moving in there. Thank you anyway.
Ooh, fair enough. Well, at least he said thanks. With time running out, they've one last place to view in the nearby fancy coastal town of Albier, only 5 miles from Benidorm.
I actually really like this. I think because it's more coastal here, it seems a really nice area, to be honest with you.
Ooh, Mr. Negative is feeling positive. But will the next pad match the mood?
Wow, this is... Oh, my God.
It's like a Garden of Eden.
This is lovely.
It's better than the other one that we came. Yeah.
Oh, what?
By a
high swimming pool too,
Does it? Perfect.
You're spoiling us now.
This is lovely.
So far, so good. But let's wait until you've seen inside, eh, lads?
Oh, no.
Wow.
Oh, I love the windows.
Oh, my gosh. Look, you can sit here, Chris, and that's the sea there. You can see the sea.
I mean, it's quite small, but it's quite...
I don't care.
Yes, one bedroom.
Wow.
And there it is, another terrace.
Oh my gosh, I'll feel like Eva Peron there every morning. Do you know what I mean?
This isn't his balcony, you can't go wrong, can you?
Exactly, we've been spoiled here.
I do really like it, I've got to be honest. There's just a really warm feel about it, and it's so airy, isn't it? It's so light.
Yeah.
And
with this place on for a similar price to the high-rise apartment they saw earlier, could a look at the pool seal the deal?
Oh, after a long day to work, we could just
come down here.
Dip in.
No, it's nice. It's a nice little place to chill out, relax. Are we going to go for this?
I think we are.
Do you think
definitely,
so?
Definitely, yeah.
Shall we?
Yeah.
Hooray! At last we have a winner, or have we? Tiffany has just had a call from the owners of the first property they saw this morning.
Okay, guys, I just have spoken with Carlos on the phone. The owners agree.
What?
Oh, my God.
A little bit less complicated.
God, I thought for the first time in my life I've made a decision.
Can we just go and have a quick cigarette and just have a think about
it? No, I don't actually decide right now. No, not at all.
Give us 5 minutes.
Yes, of course, no worries.
Lovely, thank you. When we thought things couldn't get even more complicated.
The other's a two-bed donut.
But I didn't like the height of it, I didn't.
I don't know what to say. I don't know what to do.
Oh, my head's smashed. No. What do we do?
This could take a while. We'll catch up with you later, lads. While those two try and make their minds up, back in Benny, campsite couple Susie and Waller have some good bathroom news.
Right.
At long last, we're finished. Ta-da!
We've got little wickily-pickly bits left to do, but I'm not bothered anymore because we've now got a bathroom. And, yeah, everything's done.
Almost a year to the day, they can finally go in luxury. And luxury for Susie is...
a soft-close toilet. And I must say... it goes down and it's... I must say, I quite like a toilet. I keep saying that to you, don't I, like the toilet?
Yes, not a bad toilet, that.
Only because you never put it down and it does my brain in. Look at that now, that is really good. Any minute now, it'll close.
I wouldn't hold your breath.
There you go, soft close tub, €15.
So, to mark the occasion, it's time to get the locals in for a drink. Any excuse for a party. While Susie hostesses it with the mostesses, Waller is preparing for the bathroom unveiling with a secret ribbon.
Susie has no idea about this.
I really want you to see the caravan.
Oh, well, has it finished yet?
It is now finished. Today's our final day. Hence, we're having this drink.
Yeah. Susie, everyone come on in. Let's get this sorted.
Ooh, exciting. Ladies and gents, please be upstanding for this esteemed ceremony.
Ah, I love the ribbon.
This is the end of our work, so you can cut the ribbon.
Let me read it.
And open the toilet.
Pray silence. Drum roll, please.
Yeah. Hey, there might be someone in there.
Anybody wants to say
something? There's always one. A year of mostly work on the caravan is over. What now?
So we're now officially on holiday, which we've never experienced that, have
we? No, we've always seemed to be working. But now it's all done, so I'm so excited. We can now do everything that I wanted to do, like learn Spanish, find out more about Spain.
Fiestas.
Yeah, fun. We'll be at the fiesta. We'll be at the beach. We'll be swimming in the sea. Which you haven't done yet.
So, has it all been worth it?
You know what? I'm not a sun person, I'll always say that, but there's something about the sun that makes you feel better, isn't it?
Yeah.
I love it. I just love the fact that you can come out, have breakfast, you can talk to people. Life is really, really good. I recommend it to anyone.
I'll take that as a yes. About 100 yards away, Happy Days is hoping new act Tim Ames could be the answer to his performance rotor problems. But it's a tough gig when there's no audience. Probably all heading to see Susie and Waller's new bathroom.
Tim, don't get disheartened. Imagine the room's got 200 people in it. That's how you've got to do it, isn't it?
Time to drum up some business.
Two men, a dog and some people playing pool, but it'll be all right.
Yeah.
Can you move around then? Look like a crowd, didn't you?
Right, ladies and gentlemen, good evening to the camera and Willem Army. Now I'm going to enter the world of cabaret. Put your hands together for the fabulous Mr. Tim Ames, ladies and gentlemen.
Bless you, dear boy. Thank you very much. And the crowd went wild. The small but perfectly formed crowd went wild. Thank you very much indeed. I'm going to kick off with a little song just to whip you into a frenzy.
It'll need more than a song, Tim. But 10 minutes in, the room is filling up, people are tapping along, and Happy Days is, well, happy.
I think he could be on the verge of getting a proper Happy Days thumbs up. We'll see. We'll see.
Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, just because there aren't many people in, I'm going to give this beautiful, freshly cut red rose to the most beautiful woman in the room. And tonight, Christine, my darling, I would like you to come and help me pick her.
This should give him a slot, actually.
Yeah, I'll be with
him. He's all right.
And how long have you been in the music business?
I'm Simon Cowell, and you're Louis Walsh.
Graham's got the crisp white shirt, but those collars are way too small. By the end of the show, Tim's got everyone dancing. Even Eunice is out of her wheelchair doing the can-can.
There we go. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, please show your appreciation for Mr. Tim Ames, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Tim Ames.
I thought Tim did very, very well. Typical professional. He interacted well with the audience. The songs that he chose to sing, they were absolutely spot on.
I enjoyed that. It could have been a challenge with about six people to start off with. It could have gone horrible. I'll have a word with Graham, see if he fancies using it.
So, Simon Cowell. Sorry, Happy Days. Is he going through?
We put you on the spot and you pulled it off, so...
Thank you.
I'm going to give you a go. You've done absolutely spot on.
Smash it.
Thank
you,
darling. Happy
days. See you later.
Take care. Cheers, all the best.
Bye-bye.
Ta-da.
Happy days. Coming up, Chris and Gary finally make a decision and splash the cash.
We're not like we've been robbing banks, don't we?
And it's decision time for Happy Days, the job or Jackie.
I hope he doesn't stay permanently.
Well, I'll be here this time next year.
In nearby Fancy Albia, Chris and Gary are still agonising over which apartment to take, the high-rise in Benidorm or the one here.
Oh, I don't know.
Sugar. You know, at the end of the day, Chris, where can you see us in, like, a year's time? Could you see us middle of Benidorm or here?
Well, in that case, I'm welcome home. In turn, we better take this one, then.
Would you be happy with that, also?
Also,
what? Oh, come here.
Oh, at last. Time to hand over the cash. And when I say cash, I mean cash. Gary's had £7,000 in his man bag since they arrived.
Try to help with that.
This has been my bag for 3 days, effectively, isn't it? I've slept with this. It's literally left my side.
Why am I not surprised?
We look like we've been robbing banks, don't we?
As opposed to using them. I've got to ask the obvious question. Why?
When we used to get paid, you know, we used to change it for euros. We thought it was a good way to save, to be honest with you. Every opportunity we had, we were hiding under mattress, everything.
OK. Now, almost £5,000 lighter, literally, they've somehow managed to get the keys to an apartment in one day, so there's only one thing left to do. That's right, jump into the pool fully clothed, obviously. Come on, Gary, no backing out now, please.
Probably been the most emotional day ever. Do you know what the end product is this?
And how lucky are we?
Yeah. Now we just need to work out all the motorbike jobs.
Exactly.
But for tonight, I fancy a drink.
Oh, we deserve a big stiff one tonight, love. Come on.
I think we all do after today. In the heart of Benidorm's new town, the Brit Square is waking up. So it's time for the organised pub crawl run by Graham O'Hagan to begin. But is tonight going to be a good night?
Success is 30 people for us. A good success would say 50 people. And the better luck next time is definitely a zero. But we're not going to get there tonight because we've already got the 9 people. So far, so good.
Damo, Sophie and Cam have been on the go for 9 hours and there's at least 5 more to go. It's not work for the faint-hearted.
But this is the time of the night where they can enjoy themselves, let their hair down. They do get complimentary drinks from the bars as they go round. So as long as they're having a good time, the customers will have a good time.
The number of party people might be lower than Graham needs, but at least they're in good spirits. The pedestrianised square is a Benidorm tradition. The bawdy and bonkers strip is a magnet for Brits, and one of the first things people want to do when they hit it is grab the bull by the horns, literally. And these two are going for the classic double trouble option. Oof. Hang on, has he managed to stay up? And he's down. 40 minutes into the night, more people begin to arrive, but it's not quite enough to hit Graham's target.
At the moment, I think we have around 15, 16 people. We've had messages from other people saying they're going to join us a little bit later on, so maybe the next bar or the bar after.
The idea of the night is to get strangers to become friends and bond. So next up on this mad night is the pub games. Chess? Scrabble? Bar billiards? No. Spin the bottle. And it seems to be working.
It's not about big groups joining big groups. It's about smaller groups meeting other people on holiday and having a good time that they might not be able to have as twos or threes or fours. We now make them 20s, 25s, etc. So that's what it's all about, making an experience and an atmosphere.
It's certainly been an experience.
Go on, listen up in Happy Days, Grammy in the hot seat, and I'll be back here tomorrow night at 5 o'clock. Up until then, Happy Days, our kid. See ya, ta-da. Off, 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 and me off. Knocking already. Oh, job done. Job number two.
It's 8 p.m. and Graham is back to his supposedly temporary job at the clubhouse. Time's short, so he's having the fastest of food.
Ready? 1, 2, 3. Happy days, look at that. Job done. I didn't know what to have. I was going to have something nice, like a salad, but...
Yeah.
I've seen somebody out there eating beef burger, egg and chips, so I thought that's what I'm having tonight. Welcome to Spain. Beef burger, egg and chips. Can't beat it. Right, just getting everything set up for tonight's show.
For years, Graham wanted less work and more quality time with his partner Jackie, but after finally striking the perfect balance, the lure of the clubhouse has him busier than ever, though this job is only temporary, isn't it?
Maybe in the future we'll have a bit more time to spend together. I hope he doesn't stay permanently, but it's his choice at the end of the day.
How long am I going to be here? How long's a piece of string? I don't know. For some unknown reason, we just can't seem to cut that elastic band that's tied to me in the clubhouse. So I couldn't say, and I wouldn't like to say.
Oh, come on, Graham. Give me more than that.
Well, I'll be here this time next year. If the truth was to be known. I'd imagine so. I'd imagine so. If anybody's got any scissors for the elastic, do not cut that elastic just yet. It'd be unfair. Happy days are, Kent.
Next time on Bargain-Loving Brits in the Sun, we meet Benidorm's answer to David Dickinson.
Taking it from a hobby, made it into a living.
And a living is just what Chris and Gary are on the hunt for.
She just said the same thing again, that ideally they need to be fluent in Spanish.
That's closed.
Plus, there's a severe case of puppy love.
Welcome to my new life, I know.